So I just wanted to say real quick, a lot of these pileups keep happening due to the very thick kind of mud that we were riding through. A lot of these mud pits that we ended up having to ride through, or rather run through, are about half a foot to a foot deep at times. So kids have to get off their bikes and to push their bikes through thick, slick, and heavy mud. It was just awful. right about here, I ended up running into a kid I had seen at the last race. And it had been a while since I'd last seen him, so right about here, I ended up running into him. I walked with him for a bit and just kind of talked with him, so that's why I'm walking kind of slowly.
We rode, we walked this job together. He said, yeah, he said, and like, he said I rode with a group. Dude, my back wheel is completely locked.
So up in front of me here, a kid had ended up kind of falling in the mud because it was a little bit of like an uphill kind of part, like a little lump. But he ended up falling and it was so slick that he literally could not stand up, and there was like a couple kids already there. So I ended up going up to him, I asked him if he needed help, he said yes, so I grabbed his bike and I held on to it for him while he got up and, you know, fell. But after I was done helping him, I gave him back his bike and I ended up passing him off.
Yeah, it sucks, so like, when I try to ride through a short section, like not clip in, I can't get like, I can just slip right off. It's kind of hard to clip.
right up here, I end up running into my friend that's in a lower grade than I am. And there was two separate races. There's his race and there's my race. So right about here, I was confused as to why I was running into him. But his derailleur had broken, so he couldn't really shift his bike. And also his chain had broken, so he had to walk his bike for the rest of his second lap. So I ended up meeting him on my first lap. I saw him on his second lap. And I walked with him for a little bit. I asked him if he needed help with anything. He said no. So he continued to walk. We chatted for a bit. And I left, and that was that. So right here I didn't go on the bridge because I wanted to see if I could wash some mud off my bike while I rode through this big puddle, which ended up being a little bit deeper than I thought.
Oh my god! This is... We'll be right back. GoPro on me. I wiped this off. So
So for those who don't know, or for those who don't mountain bike, what you have to understand is that this mud is extremely slick, and while it might not come across on video, if I were to actually ride fast or ride my bike through any of these, most of these parts anyways, I could literally run the risk of slipping and falling and like seriously hurting myself, because this stuff was extremely slick. Like I'm talking, I would literally walk or run a little ways and I'd literally be slipping trying to push my bike, so it was pretty bad. So right here was kind of an interesting part of the race because our wheels were all kind of covered in mud. Anytime I'd pass someone, my wheels would literally pick up and throw like super hard, like these inch wide rocks or like pebbles on this whole road, this whole section of road, until like my wheels weren't covered in mud anymore. But it was kind of weird riding by some people. They'd be like, "Oh my god, what?" Like, "Ow, there's like rocks being thrown at me." That's kind of why.
Yeah.
Right up here was a mandatory dismount because of how high the bridge we had to cross for this little river here is. So we had to get off our bikes, walk across the bridge. Otherwise, if we rode across the bridge on our bikes, we'd end up probably slipping and falling down for a ways into the water, which would not be very good.
Looking around, feeling things. Why the hell have I lost my taste?
So you might be wondering why I just let this kid pass me. So right about now is where a couple of older kids that are obviously older than my age group would start kind of coming up behind me, and you know, because they're in an older age group, they have more laps to do. And what we're supposed to do, or what I'm supposed to do, is pull off to the side for them to pass. So that's why I'm letting this kid pass. So right here, I ended up stopping and talking to a kid. The reason why the video sped up is because I stood here for a while. But right about here is where I told him I have a GoPro.
Oh shit, what's up, chat?
Anyways, we chatted for a little bit, and then right after this, we were on our way. So sadly, right about here is when, while transferring video files from my GoPro to my PC, I ended up losing one quarter of the video, which is about 15 minutes long. All that's really lost is just, you know, me riding through the same muddy sections, and then when it comes back, it's the sort of rocky road section, but, you know, it still sucks that it was lost. But anyways, without further ado, here's the rest of the video.
Lips, he's ready to end on the hunting night for life.
So right here, I tried to wash off my bike in this whole ditch here, which didn't end up really working out, so it was kind of a waste of time.
Like a hurricane. I love it. Here I am. Rocked you like a hurricane. tonight. I can barely see the road from the heat coming up. Reach down between my legs. Ease the seat back. She's mine.
So, to sum up this race, I finished with a total moving time of about 1 hour and 45 minutes. I rode about 7.25 miles, my average moving speed was about 5.3 miles per hour, with my top speed being 20 miles per hour. My elevation gain was 281 feet for the whole race, my max elevation reaching 646 feet. I placed 6th out of 28 kids for freshman boys, with my first lap having a time of 40 minutes and 31 seconds, my second lap having a time of 42 minutes and 11 seconds, and a DNF for my third lap. The reason I wasn't able to complete my third lap was because my first and second lap took too long, with the whole allotted time for my race being an hour. The race took super long due to the thick, slick, and heavy mud getting caked in my rear tire, and traffic jams with lots of other racers trying to maneuver their way through the mud. In fact, it was so muddy that a lot of cars parked in the field next to the race ended up getting stuck, including people's cars and vans from my team getting stuck. All in all, this race resulted in thousands and thousands of dollars worth of damage to kids' bikes, with derailleurs breaking and kids' chains falling off, awful stuff. And also about probably like tens of thousands of dollars worth of property damage due to the destruction of trails and fields. Like, I kid you not, the whole grassy sections of the property were turned into mud pits after the race. It was, like, really bad. Anyways, thank you for watching. I have another race in about a week that I'll most likely end up recording, so stay tuned for that video.